What is going on, everyone? It's been a couple of days. I'm back from my trip from Florida, but I am back. And I really need to address this. So Nintendo is at it again, ripping off their own fans on their garbage online. So if you don't know what happened, but I'm pretty sure everyone knows, Nintendo did their Animal Crossing Direct. It was announced for the DLC expansion, and they finally revealed the price of the N64 Sega Genesis expansion pack, and that also comes with Animal Crossing. So the Nintendo Switch Online is $20 a year, okay? So now, if you were to include the N64, Sega Genesis, and the Animal Crossing, it's now $50 a year. And the family membership is like $80 a year. Are you out of your mind, Nintendo? Seriously. Now, as you can see, the reaction is beautiful. 16,000 likes and 69,000 dislikes. Nice. So a lot of people are rightfully upset about. And I know some people are trying to damage control this, like Destiny FOMO. She's saying it's less than $5 a month. Everyone wants to lose their minds, yet you're all ready to buy GTA 5 for the 9th time. Well, let me debunk this, Destiny FOMO. It's because the Switch Online is terrible. It barely works sometimes, and it's missing features. It's such a bare-bones, archaic online service that even the Xbox Live from 2001 was better than the Switch's Online. And the fact that they're trying to make you pay $50 a year for this? Hell no. I strongly disagree with this, Destiny FOMO. You shouldn't be damage controlling this, but I'm not surprised because you're a big Nintendo fan, so I'm not surprised on this in the slightest. And also, I find funny, Mr. Harmon Smith decides to come to my channel. So again, I'm gonna stress, who is the real obsessed one here? Me or you? Because he was happy that I made a video about PlayStation fanboys, but oh boy, he's gonna lose his mind while I'm calling out his favorite company known as Nintendo. It's ludicrous because you are better off, okay, you are better off emulating these games. I know some of you are saying, emulating is a pen and all that, blah, 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 blah. Here's the thing. What do Nintendo get from these old games? These are games that came out in the mid-90s to like the early 2000s. I can understand the whole Metroid Dread thing. That's terrible. Nobody should be emulating that game. But N64 games? Come on now. Sega Genesis games? Come on now. You got the Sega Genesis Collection. You got the Sega Genesis Mini. Heck, you can hack a PlayStation Vita or PSP and play Genesis games on the go. It's just ludicrous. And it just baffles me that Nintendo decides to do this, and of course some of their hardcore fanboys are gonna eat this up, unfortunately. Thankfully though, there is seem to be a big backlash for it, and it's deserved. But I already know many people are gonna quick to defend this, and I already know. Nintendo, God, you're so annoying sometimes.